you just said, I think is critically important. Can you repeat what you just said, please?
Well, last Friday, I received a 7-page document that sort of told me that if I had an 86-year-old patient that had pneumonia but was never tested for COVID-19, but sometime after she came down with pneumonia, we learned that she had been exposed to her son, who had no symptoms, but later on was identified with COVID-19, that it would be appropriate to diagnose on the death certificate COVID-19. Now, we've not done that. If someone has the pneumonia after, and it's in the middle of a flu epidemic, and I don't have a test on influenza, I don't diagnose influenza on the death certificate. I will say this elderly patient,
sir,
died of pneumonia.
I don't mean to interrupt you, but my heart is sinking right now as you're telling me this. You're a doctor. Why in the world would they be sending you out information to fill out death certificates, whether the person's been diagnosed with COVID-19 or not, but then to say in the death certificate this person's death was caused by COVID-19? That does not sound right to me.
I went to the person in our office who does most of the death certificates over the last, 10, 20 years, and I said, does this sound right? I had her look at the documents that I printed off, and she said, well, we've always been told that you always put down just facts. You don't put down any probabilities. You don't put any presumptions down. It's just what you know. And so this is concerning, and it actually gets to your point, Chris. When we start talking about the data that goes into the modeling, we have to ask ourselves a question. Are we being forthright? Are we sharing with the public? Minnesota, North Dakota, we don't need to be having it sugar-coated. We want to know what's going into your modeling.
So with that being said, why would they want to skew the number of deaths due to COVID-19?
Well, fear is a great way to control people, and I worry about that. I worry that sometimes we're so darn interested in just jazzing up the fear factor.
You just said, I think is critically important. Can you repeat what you just said, please?
Well, last Friday, I received a 7-page document that sort of told me that if I had an 86-year-old patient that had pneumonia but was never tested for COVID-19, but sometime after she came down with pneumonia, we learned that she had been exposed to her son, who had no symptoms, but later on was identified with COVID-19, that it would be appropriate to diagnose on the death certificate COVID-19. Now, we've not done that. If someone has the pneumonia after, and it's in the middle of a flu epidemic, and I don't have a test on influenza, I don't diagnose influenza on the death certificate. I will say this elderly patient,
sir,
died of pneumonia.
I don't mean to interrupt you, but my heart is sinking right now as you're telling me this. You're a doctor. Why in the world would they be sending you out information to fill out death certificates, whether the person's been diagnosed with COVID-19 or not, but then to say in the death certificate this person's death was caused by COVID-19? That does not sound right to me.
I went to the person in our office who does most of the death certificates over the last, 10, 20 years, and I said, does this sound right? I had her look at the documents that I had printed off, and she said, well, we've always been told that you always put down just facts. You don't put down any probabilities. You don't put any presumptions down. It's just what you know. And so this is concerning, and it actually gets to your point, Chris. When we start talking about the data that goes into the modeling, we have to ask ourselves a question. Are we being forthright? Are we sharing with the public? Minnesota, North Dakota, we don't need to be having it sugar-coated. We want to know what's going into your modeling.
So with that being said, why would they want to skew the number of deaths due to COVID-19?
Well, fear is a great way to control people, and I worry about that. I worry that sometimes we're so darn interested in just jazzing up the fear factor.